Now we are discussing the topic multiplexing. Well, we already know that multiplexing means whenever we are combining the different signals together into one, that is called multiplexing. Just like if the multiple devices are there, they are sending some signals or data. Now these data are merged together and sent through the single medium, that is called multiplexing. And to just reverse, it is the demultiplexing. So now types of multiplexing. In the multiplexing, we are having two things. One is the analog and digital. Analog, we know that these are the analog signals which are in terms of sine waves. So these are the analog. And talking about the digital signal, we already know that these are the 0 and 1. So 0 and 1 binary signals are there. So this is the digital signal. Now under the analog technique, we are having the first type of multiplexing, that is the FDM. FDM stands for frequency division multiplexing. Let us suppose we are having three devices and they are working on the different frequency. Now these three frequency are merged and sent to one, so that is called the FDM. Now second type of multiplexing is the WDM, which is called wave division multiplexing. Talking about waves, we know that wave means a light wave. Let us suppose that there are three light waves which are coming and they are merged together and sent through the one. So this is the wave division. And we already know that in terms of the networking, waves are the light and they are transmitting through the optical fiber cable. If through the optical fiber cable we are transmitting the three light waves together, then this is called the WDM. And next one is the digital multiplexing. Under the digital multiplexing, we are having the TDM, that is called the time division multiplexing. Talking about the TDM, time division multiplexing, see, time is mentioned. Now we are not here to merge all the signals together. Let us suppose that there are three devices. I am giving the time slots. Now in the first second, first device can send. In the next second, another device can send. And in the next second, another device can send. Again, the term of first will come. So one by one, all are sending means medium is given for a particular second. Let us suppose that in a class, we are giving everybody's opportunity for 1 minute to speak. So that is the time division multiplexing. So let us suppose that three students are there, roll number 1, 2, and 3. Roll number 1 is getting first minute. Roll number 2 is getting second minute. Roll number 3 is getting the third minute. Again, the fourth minute is given to the first roll number and so on. So this is the time division multiplexing. And further, there are two categories under the time division. One is the synchronous, another is the asynchronous. So talking about the synchronous, it is under the time division multiplexing. Whenever the time is a major constraint, just like you have to complete something into a specific time, that is called synchronous. But when the time is not as constrained, means time should be there, but limit is not there, just like in specific 5 minutes, then this is called the asynchronous. Now I'm giving you some examples to make you understand all the frequency, wave, and the time division multiplexing. So let us suppose, first of all, I am taking the frequency division multiplexing. Let us suppose that there is a multiplexer. This is the multiplexer, I am assuming. Now we know that multiplexer is going to combine different lines into one. So now these are the three lines and this is the outgoing line. So through these three lines, the data is coming and this is the mux. Mux means the multiplexer. And here the data is coming out. Now if we are giving the frequencies here, let us suppose that this is one frequency. This is some other frequency and this is some different frequency. You can assume that there are three TV channels and these three TV channels are working on the different frequency. Let us suppose colors, ZTV or ZNews. So these three frequencies are there. Now these three frequencies are merged and combined into one. Let us suppose that this is the new shape of frequency which is going to send. So this is the composite signal. So this frequency is going to send through the medium after combining. And when it will reach to the destination, it will be just again taken back. through the demultiplexer. So this is called the example of frequency division multiplexing. Now taking the example of wave division multiplexing. Similarly, we are having the multiplexer, but see, the multiplexer cannot combine the waves. So here we are taking the prism. Now prism is working like a multiplexer. So this is the prism. We know that prism is going to combine the different light, and here prism is working like the multiplexer. Now if three lights are coming, one light is coming like this, another light, and third light. So three lights are coming at different angle. Now these three are combined together to one light. So this is called the wave division multiplexing. And now guys, you already know that these are the three different light. That means they are working on some different particular ohms. Ohms is the specific unit of the light. So when the three lights are coming, now let us suppose that this is L1, light signal 1, light signal 2, and light signal 3. So these three are merged together and sent through the single medium, and this is called the wave division multiplexing. And we know that where the waves travel, wave travel through the optical fiber cable. That means through the optical fiber cable we can travel the multiple waves, and that the multiplexer will be the prism. Now talking about the time division multiplexing, that is very interesting. It is the part of digital multiplexing. Now supposingly we are having three devices. Let us suppose that this is the device 1, another device D2, and there is a third device D3. Now they are going to send some specific data, and they are multiplexed together. As this is the time division multiplexing, so what is going to happen? Now in this particular line, let us suppose that D1 is sending the data, which is 1. First of all, 1 is going, then 2, 2 is moving, then 3, 3 is moving. Again, if D1 is giving the data 4, so 4 is moving. So this like that means everybody is given a chance. So for specific time, everybody is given a chance. So you can see that this is the 3 unit of time in which everybody is given a chance. So D1 is sending the data, then D2 is sending, and then D3 is sending. So their data are combined and sent through the single medium, and this one is the multiplexer. Means everybody is given a chance. So this is the time division multiplexer. We will also discuss all these techniques into the complete detail. This is the basic thing which I have given you. So this is the type of multiplexing, and we will also discuss all the multiplexing into the details.